I'm going to cover four normal distribution problems using a Casio 9750 graphing calculator. Healthy golden retrievers' weights approximately follow a normal distribution with a mean of 65 pounds and a standard deviation of 8 pounds. The first three questions that we're going to run through focus on finding areas under the normal curve, and the last is about finding a golden retriever weight for a particular percentile. Jump ahead to any of the examples using the times shown here. Of healthy golden retrievers, what fraction weigh less than 60 pounds? To find this answer, we'll start by drawing a plot and finding the z-score. The z-score can be computed by taking the cutoff for the area, which in this case is 60 pounds, subtracting the mean, and then dividing by the standard deviation. So 60 minus 65 divided by 8, which comes out to be z equals negative 0.625. To find the tail area on the calculator, I'll first go to the stat section by hitting menu, and then navigating over to stat. Since I want to find something related to the normal distribution, I hit F5 for distributions, then F1 for normal distribution. Next, I choose F2 for normal cumulative distribution, since I want to find an area. If needed, adjust the settings to punch in variables rather than using a list of data, using the F2 button. Here my calculator is already set on variables. Next, I need to enter a lower bound. However, I want to enter negative infinity. I'll come back to this again a little bit later, but for now I'm going to punch in a very, very negative number. Negative 1e99, which is negative 1 followed by 99 zeros. Next, I enter the z-score for the upper bound, which is negative 0.625. Then I want to make sure that I'm using the standard normal distribution. The standard deviation should be 1, and the mean should be 0. Alright, I've got my lower bound, and I've got my upper bound, which is my z-score. And I'm using the standard normal distribution, which means a standard deviation of 1 and a mean of 0. And I can hit execute to get the result, about 0.2660. Alright, now I mentioned that I wanted to come back to that lower bound, since it's a bit obnoxious to have to punch this obscure number in. Instead, it's actually okay to use negative 10 for the standard normal distribution, since pretty much all of the area under the standard normal distribution is above negative 10. So if I do the calculation again, but this time using negative 10 as the lower bound, I get the exact same result. Something else you might be wondering about is, why didn't I just punch in the mean and standard deviation from the problem? If I had, I could have just entered 60 for the upper bound. But there are actually two good reasons not to do this. First, if you're learning this as part of a class or for the AP statistics exam, you need to compute the z-score to show your work. So you might as well use the z-score here as well. Second, it would be a little trickier to know what we should have put for the lower bound if I didn't use a standard normal distribution. Well, in this case, negative 10 would have been fine, in some other cases it wouldn't have been, and it would have messed up the calculations. On to the second problem. Of healthy golden retrievers, what fraction weigh more than 75 pounds? I'm looking for the upper tail, and I again compute a z-score for the cutoff, which in this case is 75 minus 65 divided by 8, which is z equals 1.25. I should also be sure to draw a picture for this situation. To find the area using a Casio calculator, I can again punch in lower and upper bounds for the standard normal distribution. The lower bound is now 1.25, and remember how I could use negative 10 for the lower bound in the previous example? Well, I can use 10 for the upper bound in this example. This gives me an answer of 0.1056. On to the third problem. What fraction of healthy golden retrievers weigh between 60 pounds and 75 pounds? I've already computed the z-scores from earlier problems for both 60 pounds and 75 pounds, so I can just reuse these values. The lower z-score is negative 0.625, and the upper z-score is 1.25. As before, I should draw a picture showing the area I'm interested in. I can punch these z-scores into the calculator, negative 0.625 as the lower bound and 1.25 as the upper bound. This gives a fraction of 0.6284. You might also notice that this middle area could have been computed by taking the area under the normal curve and subtracting out the areas I previously calculated. In the last problem, I want to figure out what is the weight of a healthy golden retriever at the 80th percentile. I'll do this in a few steps. First, I'm going to draw a picture. Next, I'll determine a z-score for the 80th percentile. And finally, I'll compute the golden retriever weight for the z-score. So with my picture in hand, I need to find the z-score. Hopping out back to the main stat section page, I'm going to hit F5 again for distributions, F1 for normal distribution, and then I'm going to choose F3 for inverse normal. I want to make sure I'm on variable again. Then I can choose the tail area. Here I want to choose the left tail area since I'm looking for a percentile. If I was looking for a right tail, then I could use right. For the 80th percentile, I'll enter in 0.8, and as before, make sure I'm using a standard normal distribution. This gives me a z-score of 0.8416. Using this z-score and the z-score formula, I can solve for the golden retriever weight at the 80th percentile, 71.73 pounds. Before closing this video, I wanted to share the two main tricks for solving normal distribution problems. First, always, always, always draw a picture. It helps to visualize what's going on. Second, pretty much all normal distribution problems have a step of finding the z-score. So if you start with a cutoff x and need to get to a tail area, compute the z-score first. If you start with a tail area, find the z-score first before trying to find the final value itself. These aren't revolutionary ideas, but they should help you keep on track for solving normal distribution problems. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up below, and thanks for watching.